Hi, I'm Dania Krishnamurthy, Product Manager.
Hi, everybody. I'm Ramiro Calderon. I'm also a Product Manager here in the Entra team. And in this video, we're going to talk about how you can adopt a cloud-first strategy for groups using Microsoft Entra. So let's start with the why. Why are we wanting to do this in the first place? So the first thing is to know that with cloud approach, we have better security, right? So it's built in for zero trust, so you have behavioral analytics, better credentials like passwordless and passkeys. And then it allows us to have better productivity as well for our employees, more facilities to do remote onboarding, as well as self-service, self-remediation. And it also provides productivity to administrators too, because they can enable these capabilities by going to cloud console and don't have to deploy additional and complicated infrastructure that they need to design for high availability, patch, maintain, et cetera, not to mention reducing the surface area of the risk with all that infrastructure. So to enable that transformation, we have to help customers that have a very large environment, mainly on-prem, to transition over time to a cloud-only environment. We have more details in this paper that we wrote, HTTP AKMS AD to Entra ID, where we explain how to go to just use the cloud for one application in stage one to all the way to use cloud only in stage five. But before we get to cloud only, we need to get cloud first. But what do we mean by cloud first? Cloud first in this context is essentially use the cloud as the management plane to configure your security. For example, in devices, we manage the device with Intune policies, we image it to autopilot, and then use Defender for endpoint to for threat protection and so on. So that is basically using native cloud capabilities to achieve those security outcomes. If you need to get to those on-premises applications with those devices, you can do it with a Kerberos, for example. So that is cloud first for devices. For applications, same thing. New applications, then we onboard to Entra for single sign-on, for provisioning as well. And then at that point, we start reducing those dependencies for applications. But what does it mean for groups? For groups is basically similar, right? So for new groups, we create them in the cloud, and that enables all these cool capabilities around access reviews, access packages, self-service, driving membership through attributes to achieve attribute-based access control and all that. But the challenge with that, in contrast with devices, is that we have thousands and thousands of groups for largest customers in their directory. And unlike devices where over time they just fade away and then you replace with new devices, those old groups have dependencies that are not easy to remove. So, Dania, what are we going to do about those existing groups?
Now, we are going to deep dive into a feature called shifting the source of authority of groups to the cloud, which will help you achieve a cloud-first state that Ramiro was talking about. Before I go into what is group source of authority, let's talk about source of authority. It's a feature that enables IT administrators to shift the management of specific objects from Active Directory to Microsoft Entra ID. When source of authority, or SOA as we call it, is applied to an object sync from AD, it converts the object to a cloud object that can be edited and deleted in Entra ID. ConnectSync and CloudSync, the two sync clients that we have, honor this conversion and will no longer attempt to sync the object from Active Directory. By allowing administrators the ability to selectively migrate objects to the cloud, we facilitate a phased approach for the migration process. Instead of switching the entire directory at once to the cloud, which is a disruptive process, the feature allows for gradual reduction of AD dependencies. This phased approach ensures seamless operations with minimal impact on end users, as well as enable tight integrations with various capabilities within the Microsoft Entra suite. So, what does group source of authority enable? This feature enables organizations to shift management of groups to the cloud. And after you shift them, like I said, you can actually fully manage it in the cloud by editing, deleting, adding it to an access package, and managing it directly from the cloud. Once it's a cloud group, you can either delete the group from Active Directory if you no longer need it, or provision it back to Active Directory using group provisioning to AD capability in CloudSync if you have any applications tied to it in AD still. You can then use the Microsoft Entra ID governance capabilities to actually govern these applications directly from the cloud. One of the things that I do want to call out here is that you can always reverse these changes. But remember that you need to make sure that these groups are not tied to any cloud resources before you roll back any changes, which is why we treat both the group source of authority shift and rollback as operations that you have to put considerable thought into. Once you roll back the changes, the next time the sync runs, the sync client will take over the group and the group will automatically become read-only in cloud again. Now let's jump into the first scenario. In this scenario, I have an on-premises setup where I have an application and I have an AD security group that is tied to this application. This group is getting synced to Entra, and from there on, what I'm going to do now is shift the source of authority of this sync group. When I shift it to cloud, it becomes a cloud security group, an equivalent of what was in Active Directory from a group type perspective. And then now it becomes eligible for me to add it to an access package. From this point onwards, I can now use the MyAccess portal for self-service access requests to this group, and the Microsoft Entra ID governance will automatically start governing these groups. Behind the scenes, I can set up group provisioning to AD to provision this group back to Active Directory. This group provisioning to AD capability knows that this is the group that was switched because it has the same SID, and it will be able to provision members to this group automatically whenever a change to this group happens in the cloud. The second scenario that I'm going to touch upon is cleaning of groups in Active Directory. In this example, I have a security group in Active Directory, and I've had this for years, and this is the way I have been doing managing groups, where I sync it to Entra ID, and from there, I am actually controlling access to some SaaS applications that is tied to Entra ID. The reason I'm doing this is because Active Directory has been my required component, and all my provisioning goes through Active Directory, and I have to manage it there. But the application itself that was driving the need for this group in Active Directory is no longer needed in AD or no longer tied to any on-premises resources. It has now been modernized and it's available in the cloud. So with group source of authority, I can just simply convert this group into a cloud security group. Once I do that, the SID of the group is still maintained. Now the SaaS applications are pointing to the same group, but it's just a cloud group now. And I no longer need this group in Active Directory, and I can go and delete this group in Active Directory. Now, let's actually go into a demo. In this demo, I'm going to show you how you can use Entra ID governance to govern access to applications tied to Active Directory, the first scenario that I was talking about. Here, I have a finance dashboard application, and access to this application is tied through a finance dashboard users group. This group has three members, and it is synced from Active Directory to Entra ID. That's why you see this particular group as a Windows Server sourced group. So it's a sync group. Now, I'm going to use the Source of Authority API and change a property called isCloudManage, which we have introduced for this particular capability, and switch that to true. Once I do that, now you can see that this particular group has actually changed into a cloud group. At this point, I can now go and add this group to an access package. When I go and add this group to an access package as a resource, I can also go and set an approval process there where I'm saying the manager has to approve any access to this group moving forward. Now, let's look at this from an end user experience. Mike Richards is a new employee. He's joining the company and he wants to access this particular application. He gets an access denied because he's not part of the group yet. So he goes and requests access to this particular application using the MyAccess portal. When he gets into the MyAccess portal, he sees the access package to which this group is tied. He makes sure that this is the group that he wants access to and then submits the request. Once the request is submitted, it goes to Sarah for approval, who is his manager. Sarah, in the same MyAccess portal, sees that Mike needs access to this application and then approves it. As soon as the access is approved, Mike is now assigned to the access package and is now a member of the cloud group, as you can see here. Now, with group provisioning to AD, I'm provisioning this group to Active Directory, and Mike is now a member of this group as well in Active Directory. And now, when Mike tries to log into the application, voila, he has access. And that's how you can simply change the posture of your governance of AD applications by using Group Source of Authority. So, Ramiro, you saw the demo.
Yep.
You saw what this feature does and the scenarios that it's capable of lighting up for our customers. It's a very powerful feature, and with great power comes great responsibility.
So, I heard that somewhere. Yeah.
I'm going to jump into some guidelines and best practices that we think the admin should apply here so that they can get the best outcome by applying this feature and using it in production.
Absolutely.
Shall we get to that?
Yeah.
To begin with, we recommend that all admins switch their group scope type to universal before switching the source of authority of groups that they want to provision back to Active Directory, the scenario demo that I showed. Since Microsoft Entra ID doesn't have the concept of group scope type or domain namespaces, we want to ensure that any group you provision back, provision all its members without any domain boundaries involved. This is a significant shift in how you think about access control in the cloud versus Active Directory. Secondly, we don't support group SOA shift for nested groups. So if you have nested groups, you want to shift SOA to the cloud, we recommend you start with the topmost group and then move down the hierarchy until the groups have shifted to the cloud.
Dania, very good point. So I totally agree with you that this feature, just because you can do it, doesn't mean that you have to do it exactly the same way you were doing it before. And universal, converting the groups to universal is a great example. Now, I have a question on the second one, though. Mm-hmm. Like, do we see that nested groups is the end state for customers, or should they do something else as part of the transformation?
That's a great question, Ramiro. So from a cloud perspective, we ask customers to keep the groups as flat as possible from a hierarchy perspective. The reason being, from a governance and management perspective, it makes it a lot easier if your groups are flat. One recommendation that we have is that if you really need some level of structure and hierarchy, go with dynamic groups instead. This will allow you to manage membership rules through dynamic property setting rather than going and creating static group structure. So that would be our recommendation moving forward.
Yeah, and I think your point about the governance is super important. What I hear from customers is that, like, when you're doing an access review, for example, and you need to attest that people have access, if you have those nested relationships, it makes it very difficult. What is it that you are attesting to? Then the groups tend to be reused because they are nested, mm-hmm. and then it just gets out of control very quickly. So those are very good points there.
Okay, awesome. And I do have two more suggestions before, or recommendations before we move forward. The other two that I'm going to talk about is exchange constructs, specifically around mail-enabled security groups and distribution list. Today, they cannot be managed from the Microsoft Entra portal or using Graph APIs. This is the current state for these cloud groups or equivalent cloud groups. You actually have to go to the Exchange Online portal or use the Exchange Admin APIs to do so. Specifically for distribution list, our prerequisite is that you migrate all your mailboxes to the cloud before you actually think about shifting the source of authority of those groups back to the cloud. We don't support provisioning of DLs back to Active Directory today, and as well as mail-enabled security groups. And our ask is make sure that you don't have any on-premises exchange presence before you shift the source of authority. So that would be one of the things that I wanted to call out.
So I have a question about the mail-enabled security groups. So a lot of customers use those mail-enabled security groups for both granting access to resources on the security side, but also for communications and notifications and things like that. So if we cannot manage those groups with Entra for access, then what is the guidance then for customers?
So our current guidance is to leverage M365 groups for any mail-related capabilities. And M365 Universal groups have the ability to both do communications, notifications, as well as use for access control. While I understand M365 groups has additional workloads that come with it, and that's one of the constraints that customers feel using that capability, that's our current guidance, is to leverage that or continue to use mail-enabled security groups, but use it from Exchange.
This brings us to the call to action, folks. So this feature is one tool in the toolkit, but the bigger picture is modern identity management. So once the source of authority is transferred to the cloud, it lights up a lot of possibilities. So Dania talked about cleaning up the footprint in Active Directory, but more importantly, it also brings ability to govern it better, right? Access reviews, access packages, also dynamic group membership. So all those elements are part of a, you know, modern governance and as part of like a bigger picture of modernizing your environment over time. So just keep that in mind as you explore this capability. All right, folks. So we're very excited to bring this feature to you in Entra, and we look forward to see how you use it in your environments.
We have built a ton of artifacts around guidance on how to use this capability, like we showed in this video. Please take a look at it in the description. And thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for watching.